alongside former Affiliate Cup champion Adrian Conway. Bella Martin is down on the competition floor. We will hear from her in just 1 second. 11 women advancing from this semifinal to the CrossFit Games, and right now Brooke Wells is the last woman in with 198 points. All the women in this upcoming heat are looking to overtake her for that final spot. Event number four, Adrian, time to get upside down.
They're getting upside down, and they're also going to row, and it's going to start fast. They're going to row further each round, and it's going to be separate by those handstand walks at varying distance, with the middle handstand walk being the longest.
Go Ruck steps to success are
reckless on the rower. You got to start with a pace and finish with a pace. It's going to leave you breathless and uncomfortable when you've got to brace and breathe when you get upside down on those hands. Legs will be all over the place. You got to be stable in the middle.
Lane assignments for this third of four heats. Annika Greer in lane seven. Great day one for her. She worked her way up the standings and now within striking distance of that final qualifying spot. For more on her, here's Bella Martin.
Annika has climbed out from that 34th finish in day number one from the run. She's now in 14th, going into a workout that's going to be great for her. She's been right outside of qualification for the last couple years, now training alongside Noah Olsen. He was able to punch his ticket already yesterday. See if the youngster can keep up with the rest of the crowd and get into that top 11 position.
Elizabeth Wishart is another woman looking to get into that 11th spot. Now, last year, she graduated class 9 of the Indiana Smoke Divers and became the first female Indiana Smoke Diver.
Wow.
Congratulations to her on that achievement. Third of four heats underway. Time to beat belongs to Ashley Wozni. 8:45.93. She put that up in the prior heat. And we start with that 400 meter row. So Hustle Up is the official timekeeper of the CrossFit semifinals. You can scan the QR code on the screen for a chance to win a CrossFit World Tour visiting CrossFit gyms around the globe. Terms and conditions apply. Joined in the booth now by Lauren Khalil, who called the action last week at the North America West semifinal. How you doing?
It's good to be back, Sean. It's good to be
good to have
here,
you here
with you and Adrian and watching more athletes run on their hands.
That's right. Running on their hands is certainly what we saw a little bit of, especially in some of these early heats. Ashley Wozni put on a show. 8:45.93. Lauren, who do you like in this heat?
Ooh, I like Annika and I like Brooke, and both of them want to go to the games, Adrian, so my eyes are going to be on them.
There is Annika Greer, who has had just, you know, so many near misses when it comes to qualifying for the games. She's got 182 points. She's only 16 points back of Brooke Wells for that final spot. So Brooke Wells has the target on her back. She'll be in the middle of the floor now, middle of your screen in lane five. Had a really solid start to her competition. Back-to-back sixth place finishes in events one and two, but then a 26 in event three is what dropped her into 11th place overall. And now she is out of the rower along with four other athletes.
Oh yeah, we talk about walking on your hands. These women know how to do it, Sean. Brooke Wells in the middle of your screen, pretty much running on her hands at this point.
Well, Annika Greer is just slightly ahead of her. Greer's gonna be the first to make the turn. She and Wells out front. Greer's got those light blue shorts on toward the top of your screen. Shelby Neal is in the mix there as well. She's now in the middle of your screen as Neal in the long blue pants. And Brooke Wells back to the rower.
And all three of these athletes with complete understanding that the women waiting on the sidelines are going to be aware of the times they set here, so they've got to continue to be aggressive. It's not just a race between three of them. It's a race between them and the entire field. And Sean, it's going to come down to this row. We just saw right there, they can all pretty much run on their hands. So who's going to be willing to be the most uncomfortable on these rowers?
600 meters now on the rower before a 120-foot handstand walk. And these athletes are recovering in the Ice Barrel Athlete Chill Zone, prepping their bodies for the final events to come. You can head to icebarrel.com to get your own and get 15% off with the code CrossFit.
We got a little eyes closed action by Annika Greer here. Now, you can start to dream about a better place. That doesn't necessarily remove your physical body from the pain it is enduring right now.
It's like the watch pot never boils. It's addictive. The watch monitor never seems to take away meters. Like, don't look at the monitor when you're trying to rack that stuff up, because it's going to probably be moving more slowly than you want it to.
That's right. Now, there could be good and bad with this, right? Maybe this is her opportunity to detach from some discomfort. But equally, I want my athletes to be so dialed that we don't have time for this closed eyes thing. I need you to be looking at that monitor and dialing a pace down to the second so that you know you can beat the Shelby Neals and the Brooke Wells off the rower in this type of event.
Shelby Neal is one of the women that Annika is chasing in the overall standings. Neal is just one spot out in 12th place overall.
Oh, yeah.
That's about the pace you'd be rowing right now, Roar, right?
Sean, I don't want to do anything on the rower unless it's just chill.
Yeah.
That's where I sit when I need a rest.
Sean, look at this. Lane 5, lane 7. We have got a head-to-head absolute battle and shootout. Those monitors were, like, synchronized when it came to a meter accumulation.
It's Brooke Wells and Annika Greer that you were looking at. Shelby Neal in the middle of your screen. This is your top three right now in this third of four heats. Time to beat 845.93 seconds from Ashley Wozni. And now Brooke Wells is off first, followed closely by Annika Greer.
Annika being the shorter of the two, and typically the advantage on an erg going to the taller athlete, I was very impressed with what Annika was sustaining there.
They are dead even. Amanda Barnhart was the third woman to kick up in her handstand. She's down in lane number two. We'll keep an eye on her. She's got to pick up some points to move into a qualifying spot. Wells and Greer done at the exact same time. Wells makes the turn first and now has about a 2-foot lead on Annika.
Both ladies, I mean, all three of these women right here in the middle of your screen, you're doing a great job using their total body to walk, which means they're creating momentum with their heels, letting their legs relax, bend at the knee, and that's going to propel them forward with their arms.
Wells is in, Greer's done, and now here comes Shelby Neal in third. Top three remain the same. Bottom of your screen in the all gray, that's Amanda Barnhart in lane two, fighting with Chloe Gauvin-David for fourth. And right now, Brooke Wells on the same pace as Ashley Wozni from the prior heat.
Now, we talked about this a little bit in the earlier heats, but Lauren, this is the row right here that separates the women from the girls, right? To be honest with you.
Well, and knowing that Brooke Wells does have more mass than Annika Greer, she has to pull harder because Annika is just a little bit faster on her hands. And knowing that this is the last one, you almost have to just empty that tank to give yourself enough lead getting upside down.
800 meters here for this final row, and then that final walk, that's only 72 feet. There's the...
Get some royalty in the house, Sean.
Yeah, Matt Fraser there.
Here supporting Brooke Wells, an HWPO athlete.
Always loves when we put him on screen. He's a big fan of that, I'm sure.
Annika Greer, back to the closed eyes. Still focused. Hey, we saw from the monitor when we got that split action, it's paying off her. She's being able to hold herself accountable to the pace that is allowing her to lean into discomfort, but still be productive and allow her to succeed on her hands.
We'll be able to take a look at the monitors of Wells and Greer here in just a second. Greer on the left, Wells.
Okay.
On the right.
Okay. And this is where it's really going to be big, Sean. We've seen this in the last 2 weeks of semifinals. If you can walk and all things are equal, we got Wells on the right with an advantage and a lead and a faster pace. And we're going 800 meters here. This isn't the four and the six. The more time you spend on the rower, if you can capitalize, which Brooke Wells seems to be right now, this is going to allow her to have a substantial lead getting off the rower.
Top three on the screen. Brooke Wells, first woman to get to the 800-meter row. Right side of lane 7, Annika Greer was close behind her, followed by Shelby Neal in lane 6. So Annika Greer looking to pick up points on Shelby Neal.
We're getting a smile from Brooke Wells. We got two different stories of body language going on here. Annika Greer, eyes closed, squinting, a little bit of grimacing. Brooke Wells on the opposite side, a brief smile, giving her body that reprieve, almost a sensation of joy. Although, yes, I'm going to tell you right now, she is suffering. This is a very real battle that you got to face. The environment that you create for yourself will have a huge dictation on the outcome.
845.93 seconds is the time to beat. Brooke Wells looking to get in inside of that. She looks to hang on to that 11th qualifying spot, maybe even move up the overall standings and give herself some breathing room. Sydney Wells and her mom there cheering on Brooke, and Brooke is off first.
Wow. Lauren, you better start smiling when you row.
It's all about the mindset, Adrian. I've learned that from you.
Annika Greer is off second. But at the very least, Greer is going to pick up points on Shelby Neal. But no one is going to pick up anything on Brooke Wells, as she's going to win the heat and set the top time, 8:36 unofficially. And now Annika Greer in second with the second best time, as she gets in ahead of Wazzy's mark of 8:43. Shelby Neal is across. Chloe Cobb and David rolls through. Barnhart and Jordan Sheps are in. Caitlin Sanders in lane 10 coming across the finish. And Lexi Neely is done. Elizabeth Wishart in lane 8. One of two women still on the floor. Kiara Napoli is in the upper right-hand part of your screen in the background. She's still on the row. Wishart is in. Napoli still has a chance for a solid finish here, because this is by far the fastest heat that we have seen.
Yeah, one thing that'll separate athletes in their ability to get upside down is body posture and position. And right now, even as we watch here in the lanes, is it, who do we got here, Sean?
It's Kiara Napoli.
Okay,
there,
that's Kiara.
Nine.
So it's, her hands could be just a touch more narrow. You want to think about stacking your body with the understanding that power travels in a straight line most efficiently. If we could get her thumbs a little bit more narrow under her body, it would allow her just to walk a touch more efficiently.
Napoli is in, 10:26 for her. Now Brooke Wells has a new time to beat, 8:36.72 seconds. Annika Greer right now, the second best time, as she was 4 seconds faster than Ashley Wozni.
But wow, Brooke Wells came out fast. Annika Greer also battling neck and neck almost this entire event. Both ladies putting on a great exhibition of how to walk on your hands and how to do it fast. Also under fatigue. I mean, the accumulation of fatigue from both the rower and the handstand walk is tremendous here. But it was in this moment, Brooke Wells sustaining a faster pace on the longest row. And of course, sending her positive vibes to herself with a brief smile as the camera was there to film her final meters through accumulation. I think it put her off on a great foot, had a great lead going into the final handstand walk, and she did exactly what she needed to do to start day 3.
But Brooke Wells, the top time,